Welcome to the Investing Podcast, presented by Tusk Media. This is Outsider Trading, an audio and video deep dive into the people, places, and things that we find most interesting in the market.
Everybody, thanks for joining us today. We're talking about Citigroup, and this is a continuation of our review of the bank earnings of the second quarter. We've talked about Wells Fargo, we've talked about Bank of America, we've talked about JP Morgan, and we will be talking about Goldman Sachs. Citigroup was one of the weaker ones, in my opinion, this time around. I think every bank really has something that people key on. And for Wells Fargo, it's the efficiency ratio. For JP Morgan, it's just the true earnings number. And for Bank of America, it's really, do they have any crazy things going on? And how's their loan growth? JP Morgan, to an extent, with the loan growth as well. And for Citigroup, it's kind of a mixture. You want to see that efficiency ratio, and you also want to see how their various books of business are evolving, specifically the credit card business, as well as just originations in general. So this quarter, Citigroup was, it was mixed. The loan growth was relatively slow compared to the other banks. And the fixed income currencies and commodity trading was underperformed expectations. The reason it underperformed expectations is because Citi, of course, is the most global of those banks. A good portion of its revenue and earnings comes from Europe, Mexico, and India. So if rates are depressed, more depressed in Citigroup than in Europe, then Citigroup would probably also have a tougher time there. And that's what we saw in the quarter. Perhaps more notably is the weakness in the efficiency ratio. When analysts model the efficiency ratio, they like to see a gradual, almost linear decline in terms of the efficiency ratio, which of course means higher margins. Now, Citigroup set out this target for 2020 margins in the low 50s. And actually, on a quarter-over-quarter basis, the efficiency ratio popped up 58.0% from 57.9%. That doesn't help when analysts are modeling for that continued glacial decline. Furthermore, Citigroup said that of the 400 basis points and further efficiency ratio decline, they don't know how it's going to be split out between 2019 and 2020. So there could be 160 basis points of improvement in 2019, and it could be 240 basis points in 2020. And again, from the analyst's perspective, they always want a bird in the hand, which means that they're going to give a company way more credit if they actually are doing something now than if they're back-end loading all the stuff into 2020. So that was some concern with Citigroup, and it also means that it's not making that progress toward that $9 a share target as I would have hoped. Importantly, credit trends are remaining stable, even though the originations are not very strong right now. Mortgage originations, especially with funding costs rising due to rising interest rates, they're seeing the mortgage origination, those gain on sale margins shrink, which has hurt their mortgage business somewhat. Overall, total revenue growth in the second half of 2018 should be slightly above the 2% growth in the first half of 2018, but that hardly gets people excited. In an economy that's growing potentially 2, 3, 4% on a real basis this year, to have just 2% growth nominal is not something you're really looking forward to, especially in the context of a rising interest rate environment and what that does to net interest margin. Credit cards is another big issue for them. They continue to see some weakness, especially in the net revenue rate, which is how much they get on the credit cards, and they continue to see weakness. Now, they say that that's going to start improving sequentially in Q3, so that should help with the ROA going into the back half of the year as those credit card net revenue rates improve. But again, don't look for anything spectacular out of that. It's going to improve from a pretty low base, and it's not going to improve terribly quickly, in my opinion. On the macro side, on the global growth side, they're actually doing pretty well on the investment bank. They also saw pretty good growth out of the institutional clients group, both in lending and in treasury. And they did have that weak fixed income trading quarter, as I mentioned earlier. So Citigroup is making progress. I don't want to beat around the bush about that. But we are seeing issues with kind of a pushback of when that we're really going to see the stepwise change in the company's prospects as it moves closer and closer to trying to get to $9 a share in EPS in 2020. Thanks for joining us. Please check out our other videos. Thanks.
Tusk Media is a subsidiary of Narwhal Capital Management. Ratings and reviews of Tusk Media content are not to be construed as endorsements of opinions, analysis, or services offered by Tusk or its parent company. The opinions and predictions shared here are our professional beliefs at the time of publication. We are not under duress from any of the corporate entities mentioned. This is not a solicitation to take any particular action. Although we are investment advisors, this information should not be considered investment, legal, or tax advice. We strive to be as impartial, insightful, and accurate as possible. We base our opinions, analysis, and calculations on information we believe to be reliable, but we cannot guarantee its accuracy. We can, however, guarantee that our opinions will sometimes be flat out wrong due to a variety of factors. Employees and clients of Narwhal Capital Management may or may not hold positions in the securities detailed and may or may not hold these positions in the future. A full list of all securities purchased, sold, or held during the 12 months preceding the date of this publication can be provided upon request. Unless otherwise noted, all data accessed via MarketWatch or the Bloomberg Terminal. Past performance does not guarantee future results. A copy of Narwhal's Form ADV is available at the SEC's website, www.advisorinfo.sec.gov, or from Narwhal upon written request.